Hi, it's Julia from Crosspatch. Finally, we have a house. So here's the house. Coming up the drive, that's the builder's van, ready to do the new Crosspatch headquarters. Now, this house was built in the 70s, and it still looks like it's a 1970s house. We're ready for Halloween. Here's the view from the front. Can see all the way up to the mountains in the background. Okay, let's go inside. Be prepared. Get your glasses on and get ready for the swirly carpets through the front door. Hello, Charlie, and welcome to the new HQ. Right, here we go. Study is as done as it's going to be. Every available space is covered in stuff. So, my stitchery pictures, my huge storage cupboard. Joyce is back, yay. Computer and stuff, although no internet working yet. Desk and stuff. All the cushions that I've been madly stitching on my 6 weeks of homelessness. Okay, so let's go out into the hall. Let's go through. Right, this is where you need your glasses. Dark glasses. Remember those swirly carpets? Remember this red carpet? I think we had it in Chester in our house in 1972. Remember those lamps? Remember those curtains with pelmets? Charlie's playing with the skeletons on the window. So this is a lounge so far. There's a corner cupboard there, needs to go on the wall. Chaise with lots of nice stuff. Auntie Rosie's paintings on the wall. TV that doesn't work because we haven't got any Wi-Fi, not that we miss it. And yay, stitching corner is here. Slightly adapted, so we've got Auntie Rosie's picture in there. And then there's more. Garden outside, right through to the dining room. There's pictures all over the place on the floor because I gave up hammering into this lovely panelled wall after I bent about 10 nails. Okay, now this is the pièce de résistance, the 1970s kitchen. I've hardly put anything in the cupboards because they're going to be ripped out as soon as possible. So that's the lovely, delightful kitchen for you. And then we go through to like a back hall. And the dreadful, what we call the public toilet, which nobody goes into. And then we go around in a circle again. We're back in the hall now. So there's some of the friends have made a home. I'm gonna go through the hallway. So we're back round by the front door. So I've got some of my quilts up there. And then the other friends are hiding under here. One of them, as usual, has been very naughty. Granny's house cushion. Right, let's go upstairs. Because I've made an office upstairs, so I can actually start doing some work finally after 2 months. Lovely banisters, yum, not. At least the carpets up in the bedrooms are okay. Okay, this is my bedroom. So Lynette is on the wall. Let's get in so I can show you from afar. Lynette Anderson. Stitching one of her quilts that I actually managed to finish, and then one of my designs made with her fabrics. Just a dressing table and stuff. That lovely French general panel that we had, that's one of those on the dressing table there. Sorry, I'm moving the camera around very badly here. View outside. Now, it was absolutely tipping down earlier, so don't let the sun fool you. Turn round. Lynette cushions on the bed. Antique Welsh quilt. More quilts up on the top. Charlie's following me, begging for food as normal. Simon's room, because he snores, so he's got his own room with his granddad's RAF picture. Again, stitcheries everywhere. That's the cushion Lish made me. And that was a free download pattern, Kim DL pattern. I can't open the blinds in his room because they'll fall off. So there we go. Now, oh, I'll just show you the bathroom just so you can have a laugh. Now it looks deceptively okay, but it's not. The toilet leaked, which is now fixed. And now who can remember these? Yes, the all-purpose shower. Simon said, don't worry, I've ordered a shower. I think he paid £2 off eBay for that. I can remember having one of those back in 1970 something. Here we are, so let's go out of the bathroom quick. Finally, I've got an office. So, come in the door. This is supposed to be Evie's bedroom because it's got pink carpet. So I bought a load of fabric back this morning. And all the boxes I bought back is stuff that I've had ready for Create and Craft for months and haven't been able to do it because I've got no Wi-Fi. Charlie, hello, again. So we've got room to cut fabric and got the printer in here. And then you can see the mess outside. So we're trying to build a track down from the lane to make it easy to get into. That green storage shed is for my spare boxes. And that little shed there is going to be a workroom, and Carwin started work on it today. So that's about it. Hopefully I'll be up and running soon. I'm going to do a discount code soon for the website, but I'll do an announcement when I've done that because I just need to get some envelopes and stuff in stock and then I'll be ready. Thanks for watching and hopefully we'll be back to business soon. Charlie, say bye. Charlie, say bye. Bye.